Hello everyone, welcome to this session on VLSI design. Myself Dr. Sharmila, assistant professor at Krishna Engineering College. In this today lecture series, you are going to learn about the CMOS fabrication. So the learning outcome of this section is, at this end of the section you comes to know what is CMOS fabrication, what is the inverter cross section of the CMOS, and what are the different fabrication steps of CMOS circuits. So CMOS fabrication. So you know that generally the CMOS transistor consists of two types of transistor, that is NMOS transistor and PMOS transistor. So most of the transistors and ICs are fabricated using a silicon material only. In VLSI industry, so the 95% of ICs are manufactured using a silicon material. Okay. So the CMOS transistors are fabricated on the silicon wafer. So size of the silicon wafer is, the diameter is 200 to 300 millimeter. So here we are going to perform more number of steps to fabricate an IC. So that is called as a lithography process. So lithography process is nothing but the sequence of steps followed to fabricate an IC, that is the lithography process. The lithography process, which includes the photoresist, masking, etching, etc. So on the each steps, we are going to use a different material. That means while fabricating the IC, the different materials are deposited, patterned, and etched. What is the meaning of etching is? The etching is a process of removing the selected area from the wafer. Okay. So it is easy to understand the manufacturing process through top and cross-section view of the wafer. So first we are going to see the inverter cross-section of the CMOS transistor. This is the inverter cross-section of the CMOS transistor. You know that CMOS transistor consists of P-type, and that is the PMOS transistor and NMOS transistor. So here, in this PMOS transistor, first you are going to take the P substrate. In that P substrate, the NMOS transistor is formed by means of diffusing the N plus material. What is the meaning of N plus? N is nothing but your N types of semiconductor material. Here the majority carrier is an electron. The N plus indicate that these two N plus indicate that it is heavily doped. Okay. How we are forming the NMOS transistor is, in the P substrate, the N material, that is N plus, is diffused to form the NMOS transistor. Okay. So from this N plus region, we are taking the two terminals such as source and drain. So here the source is connected to the ground, okay, and then the center one is called as the gate terminal. So how we are going to take the gate terminal is, the from this polysilicon layer we are going to draw out the gate terminal. So this polysilicon layer is formed above the gas gate oxides, that is nothing but your silicon dioxides. Okay, similarly here this PMOS transistor is formed by, first in the NP substrate, first you have to diffuse the N material, okay, in order to form the NMOS PMOS transistor. You know that in PMOS transistor, the body is of N-type material and we are diffusing the P-type material, okay. So first in the P substrate, the PMOS is formed by means of, first you have to diffuse the N material, that is the N-well. After the diffusion of the N-well, we are going to diffuse the P plus. Already I told you, plus indicate the heavily doped. Okay. So we are going to diffuse the heavily doped P type material. From this P plus material, we drawn the two terminals such as source and drain. Okay. So here this source is connected to the VDD. That is, in PMOS transistor, the source is connected to VDD. In the NMOS transistor, the source is connected to the ground. Okay. Then the two gates, that is already I told you, the gates are taken from this polysilicon metal. So the polysilicon layer, this polysilicon layer is formed above this silicon dioxide. Okay. So from the PMOS and NMOS transistor, the two gates are tied together and form the terminal, that is A. Here the A is nothing but the input terminal, that is gate voltage. Okay. Then we are going to take the, considering the Y as an output. Here the Y is drawn from the drain of NMOS transistor and PMOS transistor. Okay. Here the terminal is nothing but the drain. Here the two drains are tied together and connect the, and we are taking the output, that is nothing but Y. Okay. So this is the inverter cross-section region of the CMOS transistor. Okay. And what is the use of this polysilicon is, the polysilicon layer separate the two different materials. Okay. So well and substrate taps. In this NMOS transistor and PMOS transistor, in the NMOS transistor, we are diffusing the P plus material, that this P plus material is tied to the ground along with the source. Similarly, in this NMOS transistor, the N plus material, that is, for the N plus material, the majority carrier is an electron. N plus means the heavily doped N plus material is diffused in the N-well region. This N plus is connected to the VDD. Okay. So this P plus is called as the substrate tap, and this N plus is called as the well tap. So the substrate, that is the substrate tap, is must tied to the ground, and in N well, N plus is tied to the VDD, that is connected to the VDD. Okay. So what is the use of this P plus and N plus is, it is going to avoid the forward biasing and reverse biasing. Okay. So in the P substrate, the majority carrier is the holes. In order to avoid the forward biasing conditions between the P and N type material, we are diffusing the P plus. Similarly, in this PMOS transistor, okay, in order to avoid the conductions of more conduction, this N plus is diffused here. Okay. So these two diffusions are acting as a Schottky diode. Okay. So that means we are heavily doped well and substrates or contacts are placed in the NMOS and PMOS transistor. Next, it is the inverter MOS set of the CMOS transistor. So it is a top view of the CMOS transistor. Here the transistors and wired are defined by the MOS. MOS is nothing but just like a one layer. Okay. So this dashed line indicate the cross section of the CMOS transistor. Okay. So you know that the CMOS transistor has PMOS transistor and NMOS transistor. Okay. So here the output Y is drawn between the drain of NMOS transistors and PMOS transistor. The two gates are connected together. In this gate, two gates are connected together. Here we are giving the input K. Okay. Similarly, here this N plus and this P plus is tied to the ground. In the PMOS transistor, the P plus and N plus is tied to the VDD. Okay, you know that this is a well tap. Here this one is a substrate tap. Okay, it is an inverter mask set of the PMOS transistor. So detailed mask detail, we are using a different mask, that is six masks we are using. One is a N-well. What is the meaning of N-well is, in order to form the PMOS transistor, in the P substrate, we are going to diffuse the N-type material. So this N-well is represented by this pictorial representation. Then you know what is the meaning of polysilicon. This polysilicon is connected to the both the gates of NMOS and PMOS transistor. Okay. So the polysilicon is represented by this black shade. And then N plus diffusion, you know that in order to form the NMOS transistor, we are going to diffuse the heavily doped N-type material. So it is represented by the light gray color. Okay. That is N plus diffusion. Then P plus diffusion is, in order to form the PMOS transistor, we are going to diffuse the P plus material. So that is represented by a dark gray. And then the contact is for to take out the terminals from the NMOS and PMOS transistor. So metal is for to connect the terminals. Okay. So next we are going to see the fabrication steps of CMOS. It is very important one, how they are fabricating the CMOS ICs. Okay. So in order to perform the CMOS fabrications, or I already told you, we are going to follow the so many number of steps. Okay. So sequence of steps we are going to follow to fabricate an IC. Okay. So first we are going to start with the blank wafer. I already told you wafer is nothing but the silicon wafer we are going to take, because all the semiconductor material, that is all the ICs, are fabricated using a silicon material only. So first we are going to start with the base material, that is your blank wafer we are going to take. Okay, so blank wafer is your P substrate we are taken here. So first we are going to start with the blank wafer, typically P type, where NMOS is created. If it is of PMOS, means you have to use N type material. So we are dealing with the NMOS transistor. So here I am just taken the P substrate. Okay. So in this P substrate, first we are going to coat this layer. First coating we are going to give the silicon dioxide. So this silicon dioxide is act as the protective layer. Okay. So that means it will avoid the diffusions of any other material. Okay. So first we are going to cover this P substrate with the silicon dioxide. After that, we are going to remove this oxide layer where N-well should be built. Okay. This is the P substrate material. In order, first you are going to layer the silicon dioxide. What is the use of this silicon dioxide? Is it act as the protective layer. Okay. First we are going to coat with silicon dioxide. So in the P substrate, if you want to make the NMOS, PMOS transistor, means first we are going to diffuse the N-well. Okay. So for that, we are going to remove the oxide layer. Okay. In order to prevent heat or melting, any types of melting, we are using the silicon dioxide in the remaining areas. And then we are going to implant the N-well. Once we implanted the N-well, we are going to remove this silicon dioxide layer. So first step is what? Step one, we are going to start with a blank wafer, that is called as the P substrate I am taken here. In this P substrate, second step is we are going to coat one silicon dioxide layer. So what is the meaning of silicon dioxide layer is? So just we are going to mix the silicon wafer with hydrogen dioxide or oxygen in the oxidation furnace at temperature of 900 degree to 1200 degrees Celsius. Okay. First, you have to take the P substrate. In the P, above the P substrate, you have to grow one silicon dioxide layer. How we are forming the silicon dioxide layer is, we are going to mix the silicon with the hydrogen dioxide or oxygen at 900 degree to 1200 degree in the oxidation furnace. Once you form the silicon dioxide layer, so step three is the photoresist layer. Okay, what is the meaning of photoresist layer is? This layer is mainly, what is the use of the photoresist layer is, in order to remove the unwanted area, we are just coated with the photoresist layer. Okay, so what is the meaning of photoresist is? It is light sensitive organic polymer. Okay, so what is the use of this photoresist is? Suppose if you you want to remove some unwanted area from this wafer, means we are going to pass some ultraviolet rays. Okay, so okay, we are just going to expose this photoresist region to the ultraviolet rays to remove that particular region. Okay, so third step is photoresist layer is formed above the silicon dioxide layer. What is the use of photoresist? In order, if you want to remove a particular area, means we are using the photoresist. Okay, after the photoresist, we are going to carry out the lithography. What is the meaning of lithography is? So during the fabrication process, we are going to follow more number of steps. Generally, I already told you that the fabrication is nothing but we are going to fabricate by means of just depositing the more number of layers on the silicon wafer. Okay, so that process is called as the photolithography. Generally, the steps which we are following, that is nothing but the photolithography in order to bring the desired pattern. Okay, so in order to bring the desired pattern, we are going for lithography. That means we are going to follow some series of steps. Okay, so already I told you that first we have taken the P substrate material. From this P substrate material, above the P substrate material, the silicon dioxide layer is deposited. Above the silicon dioxide layer, the photoresist layer is formed. Okay, after the photoresist layer is formed, I already told you the photoresist layer is mainly to remove the particular area. In this region, I want to diffuse the N-well. Okay, in order to make P transistor, I want to diffuse the N-well here. So for that, I am just applying the photoresist. After the photoresist, I am going to pass the ultraviolet rays. So before passing the ultraviolet rays, I am going to use one mask. This is nothing but a mask. This mask is called as the N mask. What is the meaning of N mask is? This N mask, okay, this mask is nothing but it acts as your cover. Okay, So it does not allow this ultraviolet rays to pass through this region. Okay, that's why we are using one mask over this region. Okay, in the remaining region, we are just going to pass the ultraviolet rays. If you pass the ultraviolet rays, what will happen? These regions are becomes very soft. Okay, we are not passing any ultraviolet rays over here. So this region is very hard. Okay, in this region, we are not passing any ultraviolet rays. Okay. After this one, we are going to, after we diffuse the N well, we are going to remove this photoresist material. Okay. So next step is nothing but the etching. What is the meaning of etching is, in the previous step, if you pass this ultraviolet rays, means that is using this lithography, applying this mask, we removed only the photoresist layer. Okay, that means we are passing an ultraviolet rays. Just passing the ultraviolet rays, we are using one N mask. This N mask is act as a barrier. It does not allow this ultraviolet rays to pass on this photoresist region. Okay, so once you pass the ultraviolet rays, these regions becomes very hard. Then using some chemicals, I am just going to remove this photoresist from this region. Okay, so mainly this photoresist, why we are applying the ultraviolet rays is to remove the photoresist from this region. Okay, once you remove the photoresist, we are going to remove the silicon dioxide. Okay, how we are going to remove the silicon dioxide is by using some acid. That acid is nothing but hydrofluoric acid. Okay, so what is the meaning of etching is the process of removing the silicon dioxide over the selected area. Okay, so we are going to use some hydrofluoric acid. Using that acid, just we are going to expose this acid to this region, and the region is removed successfully from this phase. Okay, that is silicon dioxide region is removed. After silicon dioxide region is removed, now next step is what? We are going to diffuse the N well here. Okay, we are going to diffuse the N well here. Okay, so the N well pattern is transferred from the mask. That is, here one mask is there. That is, N well mask is there. This N well mask is diffused over here, means the N well is formed. Okay, so next step is strip the photoresist. After, once you remove the silicon dioxide, we are going to remove the photoresist using some acid. That is, acid is called as the piranac etch. That is, the etching means what? Removing your material from this area. So we are going to remove the photoresist region. Okay, after this, now once we remove the silicon dioxide as well as the photoresist, we are going to diffuse the N well into the P substrate. Okay, so here this N well is formed by means of two method, either diffusions or ion implementation. So diffusion means what? You know that N well means what? That is a N-type material we are going to diffuse over here. So the N-type material, the majority carrier is an electron. You know what types of bond it is. Okay, so we are the N-type material is of pentavalent bond. So here this arsenic atom is diffused into this silicon, means here we form the N-type material. Already I told you this P substrate is of a silicon. Okay, in this silicon P substrate, I am going to perform a diffusion. That means what? I am going to perform a doping. Doping means what? Adding an impurities. Okay, so I am going to add the impurities over this P substrate. That is, N material I want means I am going to use the arsenic atom is diffused into the exploded silicon. So here this N well is formed. So two types of N well is formed. That is, using two method we can form the N well, either diffusion or ion implementation. Okay. Okay, so once the N well is diffused into the P substrate, the next thing is just to remove the silicon dioxide. That how we are removing the silicon dioxide is using the hydrofluoric acid. Okay, so the same process only we have to, the same lithography process only we are going to follow to remove the silicon dioxides or photoresist layers and all. Same process only we are going to repeat it. Okay, next one is a polysilicon. Okay. So here we are going to deposit, that is a polysilicon layer, you know, in order to draw the gate terminal, we are using the polysilicon material. Okay, so before we depositing the polysilicon material, first you have to deposit the thin gas layer. This thin gas layer is act as the insulator, or it act as the dielectric material. What is the use of insulator is, it does not allow any conduction between the drain to source, or that means it isolate the terminals. That's why we are using this thin gate oxide. Okay, so how we are depositing the very thin gate oxide is we are using a less than 20 degree angstrom, and we are using the 6 to 7 atomic layers over here. Then the silicon polysilicon layer is deposited using the chemical vapor deposition method. So the method is, here they are using a place the vapor in the furnace. Furnace is like some heat, okay, with silane gas. It forms a small crystal that is called as the polysilicon, then heavily doped to be a good conductor. This polysilicon is act as a good conductor. This polysilicon is just like a metal only. So it is a heavily doped and it act as a good conductor. Gate is act as a good conductor, but the layer below the gate, that is a thin oxide, thin gate oxide, that act as the insulator. Okay. So once thin gate oxide and polysilicon is formed, next we are going to remove the remaining, that is, then we are going to remove this polysilicon and thin gate oxide from the other region. Okay, how we are removing this one is, same lithography process only we are using. So lithography process means what? So okay, we are just going to use one mask and pass the ultraviolet rays, then using the hydrofluoric acid, remove the remaining unwanted part. Okay, so in this region we are using a polysilicon, that is the two gate terminals are formed using a polysilicon. Okay, so now, till now we have used a P substrate. From in the P substrate we diffuse the N well and we form the gate terminal. So next, what we have to do, next we have to form the source and drain terminal. From where we are taking source and drain terminal? We are taking source and drain terminal from the N plus and P plus. Okay, after this one, it is a self-aligned process. That is, here we are going to expose this one to the N plus dopant. That is, we are going to dope the N plus material to form the NMOS transistor. Okay, similarly, we are going to dope P plus material to form the PMOS transistor. That is PNMOS transistor. Okay, so here in this, again, we are going to perform a diffusion. This is of the N plus diffusion. What is the meaning of N plus? In order to form the PNMOS transistor, here we need to diffuse the N plus region. Okay, from this N plus region only we are drawing the source and drain terminal. Okay, so the polysilicon is better than the metal for self-aligned gate because it does not melt during the later processing. Okay, so here also same photoresist only, just we are going to pass the ultraviolet rays. So remaining areas are softened, then we are going to diffuse this N plus material over here. Okay, so similarly in the N well we are going to form the tap. That's why here I am applying this N plus diffusion. You know that N well has the P plus diffusion, that is to draw the source and drain. P plus diffusion is here. Along with the P plus diffusion, we are having a N plus tap. Okay, for that only we are applying this N plus diffusion in the PMOS transistor side also. Okay, so after the N plus diffusion, that is, diffusion means what? We are going to dope. N plus means it is a highly doped one. So here we are applying the high energy ion implementation is, nowadays they are, I already told you, two types of diffusion take place. One is the diffusion method, again one is the ion implementation. So nowadays they are using a ion implementation method to diffuse the N plus material over here. Okay, so this N plus regions are still called the diffusion. So now we formed NMOS transistor. Next we are going to put the contact over the NMOS transistor to draw the gate. But in the PMOS transistor, still we are not diffused the P plus material. So next we are going to perform the P diffusion, that is implementation. I already told you that we are going to use one mask. Okay, in this mask we are going to apply the ultraviolet, rays over here. And then we are going to diffuse using the P plus diffusion mask. We are going to diffuse this P plus material over here. Okay, now the PMOS and NMOS transistor is formed, but still we didn't take the terminals. Okay, so the next step is we are going to place the contact. Okay, so for the contact, what is the meaning of contact is we need to connect the wire together through the device. Okay, contact is nothing but here just connections between the terminals. Okay, so wherever you want the contact, we are going to use a contact mask over here. Same step we are going to perform, like etching step, photolithographies and ultraviolet rays we are going to pass. Okay, then we are going to use this contact mask and placing the contact over here. Okay, so this is a contact is formed. That means, so here this N plus and P plus, this N plus and P plus of the NMOS transistor is connected together because these two layers are connected to the ground. Okay, and then this drain of the PMOS and NMOS transistor are connected using a metal because these two terminals are connected together and we are taking the output Y. Okay, similarly in this PMOS transistor, this source and this tap, okay, source and taps are connected together. We are going to because these two terminals are always connected to the VDD. Okay, so this is the overall fabrication of the CMOS transistor. Okay, so first step, just I will recapitulate the things. So first thing is, you know that the first layer we have to take the silicon wafer layer. For the NMOS transistor, here I have taken the P substrate. In the P substrate, second step is just to place over the silicon dioxide layer. After the silicon dioxide layer, we have to use a photoresist. Okay, so what is the use of photoresist is, if you want to diffuse N-well region, we are using the photoresist. After the photoresist process, you have to pass the ultraviolet rays. Okay, so in between the photoresist and ultraviolet rays, you have to use the N mask. Okay, so that means what? It will soften the remaining area. It will harden the near to this N-well region. After this, okay, that is we using some chemicals, we are going to remove the photoresist region. Then using a etching process, we are removing the silicon dioxide layer. Okay, after that one, we diffused the N-well component. After the N-well component, we form the polysilicon gate. Once the polysilicon gate is formed, then for the NMOS transistor, the N plus diffusion is carried out. After the N plus diffusions, then we are diffused to the P plus over here. For the PMOS transistor, then P plus diffusion take place here. After the P plus diffusion, we placed a contact. That is nothing but your metallization. Okay, we placed a contact over here. In using a contact and metal, we are connecting the P plus and N plus, that is the substrate, that is P plus substrate and the source are connected to the ground. Similarly, in the PMOS transistor, this tap, this is nothing but your tap. Okay, this well tap and this P plus source are connected to the VDD. Then the drain of PMOS and NMOS transistor are connected to the output. Both the terminals, that is both the gate terminals, are connected together and applying a input, that is nothing but K. Okay, so this is the fabrication steps of the CMOS transistor. Okay, so you know CMOS is a combination of PMOS and NMOS. So sequence of steps we are following to perform the fabrications. Okay, so the main important thing is you have to know what is photolithography. Photolithography is the sequence of steps which we are following. What are the sequence of step means what? We are placing the silicon dioxide. After the silicon dioxide, we place the photoresist. In the photoresist, we pass the ultraviolet rays. So in between, before passing the ultraviolet rays, whatever the region you want to remove, in that region you have to cover with your mask. Okay, if it is of N-type material, if you want to diffuse, then you have to use N-mask. P-type material, if you want to diffuse, you have to use P-mask. Okay, and then using some chemicals, we are removing the unwanted material. Mostly we are using hydrochloric acid. Then we are performing an etching process to remove the silicon dioxide, and the implantation take place. Okay, so I hope you have understood the fabrication of the CMOS CMOS IC.